So where are we bound this fine day?
South. Far south.
Then what's there?
Not Goril, that's what. Now step on it.
Very well. South it is. Hold on to your hats.
Hey, RoboCat. You act all buddy-buddy, but we don't know a thing about you. Let's fix that.
There's not much to know. I'm a 9-to-5 nobody at a small Shinra subsidiary. Another paper-shuffling, copy-pasting forwarder of emails.
Another Shinra lapdog.
Lapcat?
My mistake.
But you lot are special. Properly special. Never met a specialer group of people in all my life. How could I not tag along?
How can I not tag along? Bullshit.
Come now, this is a road trip. We should be bonding, not fighting.
Oh. Barret, promise me. You won't take down Scarlet unless I'm there with you.
All right, I promise. If you don't give up the ghost right here and now, that is.
I won't let some stupid guard get the better of me. Not before I punch that witch right in the mouth. Oh, that's it. I can't.
Wait, just wait. We'll find somewhere to... Pull over. She's about to bomb.
Wait, Lassie! Not in the buggy! Not in the buggy!
Feeling any better? Leave me.
Where to now? We don't have any leads. And driving in circles, hoping to spot a black robe is...
The worst idea ever!
When you don't know where life's leading, you should get yourself a reading!
Ooh!
Meow, 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 meow.
Your lucky food is mushrooms.
Mushrooms, eh? Mushrooms.
Wait! Barret, you mentioned something earlier about the Corel reactor, did you not? You saw a weapon there, right?
Yeah, but I don't recall telling you.
Well, it might interest you to know that just a wee drive from here, there's another rundown reactor.
Reactor? Materia! Okay, I'm good. Everybody, back in the car! Let's go, go, go!
Well, couldn't hurt to check it out, I guess.
My, just a wee drive from here, so it is. Shall we?
Why not?
Oh, Cloud? Mind taking the wheel?
All right, float it south through the sands till we start seeing green. We'll be pulling up outside that reactor before you can say Mako. Well, this reactor's smack bang in the middle of a place famous for, you guessed it, the world's favorite fungi.
Ooh.
Mushrooms grow near a reactor. Yeah, I'll pass, thanks.
Cloud. I've detected proto-relic signals emanating from a nearby modular reactor. I'm sending you its location. It looks like
Uh-oh. Sandstorm must have kicked up or something. Transmission go through?
Yeah.
Thank you.
this ship right here! Bring it home!
That's a fortune teller!
Begun to fulfill your potential. Long have I awaited this day. At ease, young soldier. I took your measure the moment you set foot in this town. Hard not to, given your presence. I am Navalan of the Thousand Eyes. Years of meditation have granted me sight beyond sight. It is this clarity which shows me all. Even that which some wish to keep hidden. You exude a powerful, yet troubled aura. Indeed, it makes you the perfect opponent. Come, and don't you dare hold anything back.
Thank you. my name is Ludrell Balmont, and I am the creator of the game Queen's Blood. Which means that this nightmare is of my own making. I didn't know. How could I? You hear her too? Time's running out. She's calling me. Commanding me. She's made me her prisoner. Her cursed guard, my shackle. The end is nigh. Or perhaps this is only the beginning. The Shadow Blood Queen is...
Ah, let me guess. You have dreamt the dream of Ludrell Balmont too.
What do you know about it?
Only rumors and hearsay that players of particular skill have experienced strange visions of late. Visions in which one is visited by the ghost of the game's creator, who speaks of portentous events. To add another wrinkle, some of the world's very best have recently met with unnaturally violent deaths. People are calling this the Curse of Ludrell. Not even my third eye can discern the true cause, though it is clearly something sinister. If you wish to continue on the path of the card, then remain vigilant. It may lead to your undoing.
What you looking at? This water.
I hope you
had no honest.
Been out of work for ages.
You stole everything from us.
Sorry! I'm sorry! I promise I'll do it right next time!
This place is great. In 4 years, not a day goes by.
Shinra throws us a bone every so often, you know.
Children of the planet, hearken to our mother.
You talk to this old fella instead. He's tough, tougher than he looks, and real good at solving people's problems, right? Of course, I'm soft on kids. Helping them's what we do.
News to me. Well, what's the problem?
You see, Mr. Birdie ran away and hasn't come back.
Oh, Mr. Birdie is a bird friend of ours? His head is all pointy. Kinda like yours, mister.
Pointy, huh? I bet they're talking about Cloud Jr.
Who's that?
Your bird friend. He had a run-in with a nasty fiend, and we saved his tiny behind.
No way!
You guys, Grandpa said he saw Mr. Birdie heading toward the desert.
What? But we aren't allowed to go all the way out there.
You just leave it to us. We'll find your friend.
Really?
Promise.
Great. Grandpa said there's some old birdhouses out in the desert that people built back in the Republic days. He said those are good places to set traps.
Oh, and my mommy told me you can craft them yourself if you've got the right chip.
In that case, we'd better figure out how to transmute us some traps.
I heard about your plight. If you wish to learn more about the Republic of Junon, I recommend visiting Life Springs. The knowledge they contain will reveal the location of transmuter chips.
All right, then. Let's go find our bird buddy.
He'll definitely be happy to see you.
At least somebody will be. I understand there's no making amends for how I did these people wrong, but I want to help. I need to help.
What happened with the reactor wasn't your fault, you know.
I could have told you that. No, I ain't the one who proposed building the damn thing. That was Shinra. Just hitched my wagon to it.
Right.
Took a while to accept that, though. Hell, I did everything in my power to avoid thinking about it at all. Eventually, I realized the excuses I was clinging to weren't making me feel any better. What happened in Corral, that's my burden to bear.
Just don't go breaking your back.
Yeah, well, it's stronger than you think. I won't pretend it's all for the kids. End of the day, I'm doing this for me.
Grandpa said in the old days, they used to trap birds all the time.
What? But why would they hunt their friends?
They didn't hunt them, just caught them for fun and stuff. But Grandpa said you can't find traps like that anywhere anymore.
So we just gotta make new ones instead. If he's out here, he must be pretty thirsty. I hope he finds some water.
Down in Corell, whenever humanity strays from the proper course, Alexander appears to render his righteous judgment. His pronouncements are absolute and cannot be defied. Let's hope our investigation of other shrines goes as smoothly.
dangerous territory then.
Rare landworm variant identified. Commencing guidance protocol. Their eyes having long since atrophied. These creatures rely on their sense of smell to hunt. Their digestive system has also deteriorated, forcing them to ingest rocks to break down food and absorb nutrients. Referred to as the Undertakers of the Desert, these fiends subsist almost exclusively on carrion. Extreme hunger, however, can drive them to attack living prey. The Gold Saucer has led to a steady increase in foot traffic. And, as you might imagine, a corresponding increase in landworm-related deaths. To protect these travelers, we must understand what makes this variant tick.
Leave it to me!
Victory is all but guaranteed!
You like taking over?
Alright! Watch it learn!
Hang back.
Wow! What a fight!
Keep it together.
I'm gonna take this thing!
I got
enough!
Oh!
You're
coming out!
Now that's it, Siri!
You're gonna
And say I'm surprised!
That's your weak aim!
Your strength knows no bounds!
What does your future hold?
I got this! Feeling good. That was
is on you. Let's do this. Take the lead. Whatever. I'll finish it.
This must be the sandstorm.
Sweltering sands!
What is this thing?
No way.
What misfortune for you to venture so far for treasure already claimed. You would do well to leave, that I may collect what is by rights mine!
You think the proto-relic is yours?
Proto what now? Relic, you say? A ridiculous name, unworthy of my treasure! What you knaves covet is none other than a prize in my resplendent arsenal! This form! I can hold no longer! Down I go!
Oh, what was that?
Oh, thank goodness I finally got through! Are you alright?
I'm fine. But what the hell was that just now?
I'm investigating the matter as we speak. In my initial analysis of the sand entity, I detected a proto-relic-like signal. I'm unsure how they're connected, but I fear we might be after the same thing.
Of course we are.
There's no telling where it might appear next. Please, be careful.
Ah!
Growing stronger. Perhaps there is a proto-relic in the nearby reactor.
You mean that thing?
It's been altered. Though it doesn't appear these modifications were made by Shinra. Whoever's responsible may be waiting within. Proceed with caution.
It's some sort of monster's den. A fortress, if you will.
Whatever it is, I don't think we can get inside.
Commencing scan. I believe I have a match. The symbols resemble those found in the Book of Kings, an ancient tome. Allow me to translate. Interesting. Well then, in order to unlock this door, you'll need to locate a cactuar rock hidden somewhere in the desert.
What kind of rock?
A mineral deposit named for its distinct cactuar shape. Now that Cloud has made contact with this door, the rock we seek should be marked by a green glow. By the way, do you happen to see a cactuar-shaped statue anywhere nearby? That's it! That statue should guide you to the rock I spoke of, which in turn will serve as the key to the door.
So we must prove ourselves worthy.
I know you can do it.
Get my don't hope you don't mind if I fill you for a hole.
Deal with that.
Be ready for it now.
Nothing to it.
Gosh,